What's cracking with you people? This is the Devious Wolf and welcome back to another iteration of Let's Play Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. In the last one, we discovered that our two home dogs, Big Smoke and Rada, done stabbed us in the back. Been stabbed us in the back. And are probably responsible for the death of our mother. And then we went to go see our brother Sweet. He got shot. He's presumably in jail. And now we gotta do some dirty work for Officer Tenpenny and Pulaski. Mostly Tenpenny. But for right now, they left us with no weapons.
You can legally own a gun.
So, we're gonna go ahead and buy a gun. We're gonna buy the silenced 10 mil, the silenced pistol. I'm not about to pretend like I know what I'm talking about here. That should be enough ammo. You really don't need to buy that much. Micro SMG. Let's get the tech since it's a cheaper gun.
If the cops ask, you didn't get it here, okay?
And that's two for that. And get some body armor too. You never know, you might need it.
Have fun.
I somehow do not think body armor stands up like that. Call me crazy. Maybe it does, and I'm just stupid. An SMG. It's the SMG. And we don't have any assault rifles. Ooh, the sawn-off shotgun. Well, we'll stick with the shotgun for right now. No, we'll get two of that. And that should be good to go. And then we're going to start our mission and just see what happens from there.
There are cultists everywhere, friend.
Yeah, the ammunition guy will just say random stuff to you. And I honestly don't remember all of them, but eh. What are you going to do? Now we're going to go ahead and do our next little mission here. And just see what happens. You gotta kill the witness and bring back proof. So if you have this camera here, okay, yeah, you have to just right trigger to look through it, and then use the right bumper and left bumper to zoom in and out. And I believe left trigger takes the picture. Nope, B takes the picture. Make me a liar, why don't you? Okay, and gonna need to bike for a minute. And gone. So yeah, we're essentially a gangsta brother out here in redneck territory. This can only end so well, but surprisingly that doesn't really occur. That doesn't occur at all now that I think about it. I don't think they actually have that kind of commentary in this game, just because, even though, like I mentioned earlier, you know, they show races of, like, more than one point of view. Like, the one thing they don't really show is a lot of classical racism, at least what you think of when you think American racism. And I think that might just because it might be too much of a touchy subject. Now, from what I recall, apparently Mafia 3 is doing a little bit more of that, and that's a game I would like to get my hands on one day. I might play it blind for the channel, I don't know. Which brings me to a quick question so we can get off this tangent. Would you guys like to see me do more blind commentaries? My bike skill is not high enough to where I can't take that drop without a problem. Yeah, that road I was taking was a different road. I think this is Mount Kilimanjaro. Not really certain. But would you guys like to see me do more blind commentary? Like, I mean, sure, I sort of. I mean, I'm serious. Like, so far, most of the stuff I've done have been games that I am fairly familiar with. I run my mouth, I say some stuff, probably look too deep into stuff that I really don't need to look that deep into. But, if I did do more blind commentaries, you know, a little bit more off the cuff kind of stuff, would you guys like to see it? Okay, it was right trigger to target. Okay, I have to remember that. Now this is technically a stealth mission, but yeah, it's a really awkward one. But yeah, it's like, if I did more blind commentary, the main reason why I haven't done a blind commentary yet is because, well, for the most part, I'm concerned with it being sloppy. Like, this isn't already sloppy enough as is. But, I would like to try that out. It was getting away. Okay, so, now, essentially what you have to do is you have to get in this car, get in a car, and run them down. Any more ammo I can get real quick? Nope, they disappeared. Okay. Okay, CJ, I'm gonna need you to get on the bike. But, because I did do more blind stuff, which I would have no problem with doing, I just don't know what I would do blind, you know? Like, I have a few ideas, but if I did more did he really get away? Holy crap, he got away. A little less checkpoint. Okay. Now, is this him running, or... No, put this right back here. Okay, so we're going to try this a little bit differently. What we're going to do, we're going to try to sneak into the house, shoot him, and then shoot the feds. Just got to watch the pattern. See who's where. Run up in there, shoot the guy in the head. And then go from there. So, doesn't look like there's a break in the line at any point in the game. See, he stops. Is there a back entrance? There is. It looks like there's a big pause here at some point. That maybe I'll take advantage of. Actually, no, I don't trust that. I do not trust the sensitivity on this aiming to pull that off properly. But no, there is a back way in. Okay, so now that he's dead, I can just do this right here. Silence pistol, I think, is the most powerful gun in the game. Well, not powerful gun. That's obviously a blatant lie. I think it's the most powerful handgun in the game. Second most powerful. I just remember the most powerful one, and it's okay. So let's photograph the body. And take the camera to the drop. And go from there. See, I've always done that mission where I just shot the guys and then chased them down, but that actually was a pretty interesting way to go about it too. But yeah, I am curious about like how that would be received. Like, would people be like, would you guys be interested in me doing a more off the cuff kind of commentary style? Because what it would be is like, okay, let's take I used Mafia 3 earlier. Let's just take the Mafia series in general. I know nothing about those games. I don't. But what I know about those games from growing up is that they're a mix between the Grand Theft Auto games and the Scarface game that came out like early 2000s. So that Scarface game was pretty dang good. It was an original Xbox game. But it's essentially like a mob Grand Theft Auto, but it's a little bit different. It's a lot more organized, you know. It's like a much grittier Grand Theft Auto, I suppose. And I would be interested in playing that just to kind of see how that panned out. But hey, let me know what you think. Because I'm still going to do commentary things that I'm fairly familiar with. But blind commentaries are something that I have been debating about doing for a good minute. Now, also, I do not think this is a safe house. I think this is just a place you can save. Yeah, because you can't go inside of it. This is just a place you can save. Okay, pass the mission. Let's go ahead and save real quick. And there we go. Well. What now? Oh, got a call.
Caesar, it's me.
Carl, you all right, Holmes? Your sister's been worried. I heard some shit went down.
Yeah, Los Santos is dangerous right now. I'm out in the middle of, I don't know, what, Whetstone or... whatever that is.
I don't know Whetstone too well. I got some family out there, I think. But at least you ain't in jail, Holmes. Shit's fucked up with your brother, is it?
You be careful and look after Kendall.
Don't worry about me, man. You worry about the man who tries to fuck with my woman. I got some backup coming out to protect you. My cousin. Really intense, Holmes. Trust me. Meet them over at the diner in Dillymore over in Red County. You won't miss them.
And this gets us into something about San Andreas that I needed to look up a while ago. But Caesar has a cousin. See how much money we got? 4,000? How much is this extra house over here? How much is this extra house over here? Let's take a look here. This appears to be a home. This is, oh, there's a free thing of body armor over here. I often forget that you can just find guns lying around. And Grand Theft Autos, 20,000. Ooh, that's a bit pricey. And the reason why I forget that is because Grand Theft Auto 4 and 5, they really, I don't recall them ever having guns just randomly lying around. You know, now you can buy guns, you can get guns off of people you kill, but because the guns don't float in the air. Quad bike. I think those were pretty much removed from later Grand Theft Autos. I think Grand Theft Auto 5 may have one, but I don't remember. But because the guns don't float, you just won't find them randomly lying around in a random alleyway or something. So I have to remember that you can just find guns randomly. But yeah, the thing about Grand Theft Auto is about San Andreas is that Caesar has a cousin. His cousin is somebody very familiar to those who played Grand Theft Auto 3. I gotta improve my bike skill. Oh, I got a phone call.
Carl, it's me.
Sweet, what's going on, man?
And what the fuck you think is going on? I'm in the prison hospital, nigga.
I know. You alright?
Hell nah. You gotta do something, man.
I'm trying, man. I just gotta make sure Kendall's safe first.
Alright, man, I gotta go.
Don't worry, bruh. I ain't gonna leave you in there.
Got a call from Sweet. Got apparently that's just one phone call. Now, do you get one phone call a day or just one phone call in general? I don't know. I've never been in jail. But, here's hoping I stay out of jail, if you know what I'm saying. But with the way things are going nowadays, it's very possible you can get put in jail just by saying the wrong thing. Yeah, what are you gonna do? Maybe that'll change one day. Maybe not. Who knows? But, Caesar's cousin is somebody very familiar to those who've played Grand Theft Auto 3. Which kind of blew my, which I didn't hitch on at first when I first played this game through. It wasn't until my second playthrough where we met a couple of characters that it finally hitched that, oh, my bike's going up. That, San Andreas is a prequel to Grand Theft Auto 3. San Andreas is indeed a prequel to Grand Theft Auto 3. And I think every Grand Theft Auto does share continuity with the actual series. Granted, it's a weird continuity, but it does share a continuity. Just trying to remember, which way to go here. Oh, this is Los Santos. Yeah, that's Los Santos right there. So we need to go over here. We need to go over here. Let me see here. Traveling on a country road. He's gonna travel on this country road and see what the heck happens. But, I think you gotta go this way here. And when we meet this cousin, I can kind of explain a little bit more. But for right now, I'm just gonna tap dance around the issue like some master of narrative tension that I am not. I'm just not. I'm not even gonna pretend like I am. I mean, if you've seen some of my other works, seen some of my other stuff, you pretty much know how I feel about narratives and whatnot. But as far as actually being able to properly time my beats, oh, buddy boy, no. Mm-hmm. Now, usually that would kill you in Grand Theft Auto 4 and 5, just because the physics are mostly more realistic. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, you can go flying a good distance and not die. Like, it is ridiculous. And here's this over here. And this is another house. Is this just 20K as well? This 2K? Yeah, this is 40K. Yeah, we will not be making that kind of money anytime soon. Which is odd to me because I've always had enough money to buy the houses as I get to them. It's just something I'm used to. This is not. At any rate, let's go meet Caesar's cousin. Wait, I gotta get off the bike.
Do you want some, Fetzer? You big string Yankee piece? I sing fucking units with more balls than you. What the fuck did you want?
Nothing. I'm looking for a friend of mine's cousin. Come on, Mexican bitch. Guy. Off, he ain't here.
You? But Cesar said you was a real man.
Priest. Lady, bitch. I'm a God-fearing, peace-loving man of the people.
Whatever, asshole. Let's go.
Damn, relax, baby.
Where's your car?
Where's yours?
Ladies don't drive themselves. That's what men are for.
Oh, my goodness. Thanks, Caesar. Appreciate this, homie. So, what's your name? Where we going?
My name is Catalina, and we're gonna take this county for every stinking cent.
Okay, good plan, I guess.
You're damn straight it's a good plan. I've cased 4 soft targets. A liquor store in Blueberry, a bank in Palomino Creek, a gas station in Dillimore, and a betting shop in Montgomery.
Hold up, which one first?
You're the driver, you dumb pig! You choose!
Okay. This is Catalina.
You pretty high strung, huh, lady?
Yeah, and what are you? Some laid-back gangbanger dude?
I keep myself to myself. That's my style.
Sister says you got a brother in jail. Another brother dead, a mother just killed, and you got a bad cop on your case.
I ain't listening to you.
You think that is keeping yourself to yourself, eh, amigo? Real cool. You're just an idiota.
And you're real charming, a proper lady.
Oh boy, this is gonna be a fun one, so...
Hand over the tankings or I blow your fucking balls off!
This is bulletproof glass. So you can just fuck off, bitch, before I call the sheriff.
What are you doing, son? Just give her the cash.
Suit yourself, maricon. Change of plan, Carl. We're taking the tanker.
Hey, what you doing?
Alright, so... Yeah. This introduces a mechanic that Grand Theft Auto San Andreas introduced, and that's hooking up trailers to trucks.
I ain't losing another crappy job because of some crazy bitch. Come on, Derek, we're gonna stop those bastards.
Do I have to?
Drive! I know a guy who'll pay for this rig and its cargo.
So how this works is that you essentially need to protect this tanker at all costs.
Keep up with him. This ain't my fight.
And you can't let them shoot the tanker too much or else it explodes. Now there are several ways you can go about doing this, but you have to be very, very, very careful with it because it's a tanker. It can flip very easily and it can blow up very easily. But this is a Catalina. A character from Grand Theft Auto 3. I'm not certain we're going to get into the whole thing today, but right now all you need to know is that she's a very, very, very intense woman. Like, she is one of the most intense characters I think I've ever seen in the game, period. And her missions work is that she already gave you all four of her missions. You just have to do them. Some of them are easy, one of them is very tough.
Hello, Mr. Whitaker.
Catalina, what have you brought me today?
A rig and tanker, full to the brim with premium gas.
Never seen it, never saw you, never gave you this wad of cash.
Nice not doing business.
Likewise. Now get out of here before the cops come snooping. You ever want to run some freight for me, just drop in. I've always got shit to move.
Goodbye.
What happened to women don't drive, that's what men are for. Now you can do tanker missions here. And, well, trucker missions, and I've never done them. At all. And before we get into that, let's answer our phone.
Yeah.
Carl.
Who is this?
You know me. This is the truth.
No, I don't.
Perfection. They said you were a moron.
Who?
Okay, you can drop the act now, kid.
You the police?
No. We have a mutual friend and business partner.
We do? Who?
Yes. Have you killed any cops lately?
Aw, man, Tenpenny. I should have known. That asshole.
So I've got a room at a motel in Angel Pine. Make sure nobody follows you.
Oh, boy. I don't know if that's the pie sign or just the letters TT, but I'm not in the mood for this. Now, something that if I was a better player at, I probably could show you guys, because I was not aware of this until I think last year in college, where a friend of mine told me about a glitch you could do. And Grand Theft Auto is full. Grand Theft Auto, the early ones at any rate, are full of a lot of glitches. Like, a lot of glitches that make the game fun, a lot of cheats that make the game fun. This one glitch is in some ways a cheat code. And how it works is that during that tanker mission, as you saw, there's a car that the guys were driving drove into a gas station, blew up, and destroyed a pickup truck. Now, I believe that pickup truck changes what kind of truck it is per playthrough, but it's always a truck. However, if you get out, kill them, drive all the way to this location, get the truck, drive it to a garage somewhere if you have one, if you have a free spot, drive back, get the tanker, do the mission. A, their car will show up as if they've never been killed, so that just makes it real awkward. And two, the truck will be there. At least I think that's how it works. I have to ask them again to get the full details, but essentially you'd have a truck that never blew up. Let me go and check the map real quick. I don't like checking the map during the game, but I think I have to for this point. Okay, so left bumper zooms out. This is where we've all been. Now, thankfully, he has a... Where is he located? In a motel. Oh, okay, so it's right over here. Okay, I thought I was on the right track. I just gotta loop back around and get on. Just gotta loop back around then. Now, I've never done it. I've never heard of it. I don't know how to do it myself. So we're just gonna keep going. You can probably find a tutorial about it on YouTube, honestly. Maybe at a later day I might show it off. I don't know. But yeah, that's how it works. So, as you can see, though, we are no longer in Los Santos. We don't have access to a lot of the stuff that we did in Los Santos, which is why I said don't worry about the gangland stuff, because, well, about the gang territory stuff, because literally, like, after they introduce it, you're taken out of the place, and you can't do anything with it again. Now, that doesn't mean that was just for that one segment. That segment will be showing back up because, well, we're not going to be out of Los Santos for long. I mean, I think anyone could see that coming. Now, here's the kicker. We have a girlfriend in Los Santos. And we're supposed to date her to get something or other. I can't remember what it was. Okay, let me check the map again. The map one last time. I'll admit I don't have this place perfectly memorized like I used to. I used to have this entire map memorized down to a T. I could literally find my way anywhere from where I was. I knew where all the landmarks were. I knew what street. I didn't know the names of them, but I knew where I was. Not anymore. But yeah, that's essentially how that works. We're just going to. People still can't drive, even in games. How do you like that? Yes, I'm well aware I was going too fast, but still. But yeah, it's just, what was I getting at again? I was getting at something, now I forgot what it was. Huh. Yeah. Glitch and indestructible car. And there was, oh yeah, Catalina. Yeah, she's in the, she's in the opening third game. She shoots you. As the main character of Grand Theft Auto 3, you get shot by Catalina in the opening minutes of the game. I left her dead, and the rest of the game is just you. Honestly, I don't know, because Grand Theft Auto 3 is the only game that I have not done a single story mission for. I have done story missions for Grand Theft Auto Vice City. Never beat it. I played a few of them. Never beat it. Grand Theft Auto 3? Never. Not once. So I don't know what the main character's deal is. I do know that he's a mute. And I would spoil what happens at the end, but I'm not. I'll think about that one. I have to think about if it's been long enough that spoiling what happens at the end of Grand Theft Auto 3 is really a big deal. But you do get involved with a lot of crazy people in Grand Theft Auto. But I think it's a selling point. You just have so many big personalities to deal with. But before we get more and more into that, before we drive to our next mutual colleague, I should say, let's drop a save real quick and go from there. I've been Devious Wolf, and I'll catch you later.